Hello children, hope you all are well. May God bless you. I am Divya Yadav, your EVS teacher.
I am going to explain the 8th chapter of class 4, that is Bloom and Grow. Before I explain the chapter, let me first tell the topic that I am going to cover in this chapter. Different types of roots, function of roots, edible roots, roots affected by construction, paving, plastering, importance of flowers as part of plants, parts of a flower, plants that have flowers, flowers and their lifespan, flowering season, who is attracted to flowers, uses of flowers, journey of flower from garden to flower cellar. Recap short. Children, plants are one of the largest group of living things. The body of a plant is made up of different parts that perform different functions. They help plants to grow, obtain food, and stand upright. Parts of a plant. The body of a plant is divided into two parts, shoot system and root system. Shoot system. The part of the plant that is above the ground is called the shoot system. It consists of stem, branches, leaves, flowers, and fruits. Stem bears leaves, fruits, flowers, and branches. Leaves make food for the plant. Flowers turn into fruits, and fruits bear seeds. Root system. The part of the plant that is under the ground is called the root system. Root grows deep down inside the soil. Different types of roots. Roots are mainly of two types, taproot and fibrous root. Taproot. Some plants have one main root with many small roots branching out of it. Such roots are called tap roots. The main root grows vertically downward into the soil. It has many smaller and thinner roots called root hair along the sides. Examples: carrot, radish, mustard, sunflower, etc. Fibrous root. Some plants have numerous roots roughly of the same size growing from the base of the stem. These are called fibrous roots. These are a cluster of roots coming out of the stem. Fibrous roots do not go deep into the soil. They binds the soil tightly. Examples: grass, wheat, rice, maize, etc. Aerial roots. These roots hang from the heavy branches and grow vertically downward and penetrate the soil. They absorb water from the air and support the heavy branches of tree. Banyan tree, orchards, etc. have such roots. Children, banyan tree is the national tree of our country. Storage roots. Roots that store extra food are called storage roots. Extra food made by the plant is stored in the root of some plants in the form of starch. During shortage of food due to crop failure, flood, drought, or famine, people eat them as food. Children, famine means shortage of food. Carrot, radish, beetroot, and sweet potato are storage root. The roots of asparagus and pumpkin store water for the plant to be used in hot summer months. propagative roots. Some plants can multiply with the help of their roots. These plants produce buds along the roots that grow near the surface of the ground. As these plants propagate with the help of their roots are called propagative roots. Cherry and strawberry plants have such roots. Breathing root. Breathing roots are found in plants that grow in salty water and marshy region. In marshy area where the soil is waterlogged, roots grow above the soil to help the plant to breathe. Mangroves have breathing roots. Buttress root. These are large roots that grow on all sides of a tall tree. The roots support the plant and allow it to absorb more nutrients. These roots are found in the tree of tropical rainforest. Children, buttress roots are found in trees that grow in area where the soil is not rich in water and mineral and do not grow deep into the soil. As these trees grow bigger and taller, their roots cannot provide enough support to the tree to stand straight. Therefore, buttress roots grow from the trunk of the tree, sticking out at the base on top of the ground to provide additional support. They also absorb extra nutrient from the soil. Buttress roots form meshes on the ground and provide support to tree. Fig tree and yellow carabine have buttress roots. Functions of roots. Roots have following functions. Fixation. Roots spread out to support the plant and bind it firmly to the ground. They prevent the plant from getting uprooted by strong winds or storms. Children, meaning of uprooted is that a plant that has been pulled out of the ground along with its root. Absorption. Root hairs help the plant to absorb mineral and water from the soil, which is then pushed into the stem to prepare food. Storage. Many roots store food. This helps the plant to survive. Support. Some roots grow above the ground and provide solid support to the tree. Prevents erosion. Roots prevent soil erosion because they bind the soil particles. Soil erosion means, children, blowing away of the topsoil by wind or water. Food in emergency. Sometimes there is shortage of food. In such situation, which is often referred to as famine, people survive by eating some roots. Respiration. In some trees, the roots of the tree grow upward from the soil. These roots have tiny holes in them which help in respiration. Edible roots. Vegetable like carrots, radish, and tapioca store food in the form of carbohydrate. We eat them as vegetables. They are called edible roots. Carbohydrates give us energy. Roots affected by construction, paving, plastering. Children, in towns and cities, constant work in concrete construction goes on. Pavement are paved, plastering is carried out. The roots of tree need to spread deep and wide, but they are unable to spread because of the construction, paving and plastering. So these trees fall down easily when a strong wind or strong blows. Importance of flowers as parts of plants. Children, flowers are the most beautiful part of a plant. As you can see in the picture, they are responsible for the birth of young new plants from the old plant. They are found in different colors, sizes and shape. All flowers grow from buds. Buds open to bloom into a flower. Parts of a flower. Children, you can see different parts of a flower in the picture. A flower has four main parts: petals, sepals, stamen and carpel. Petals. These are colorful parts of a flower. The petals attract bees and butterflies with their bright color and pleasant smell. Sepals. These are green leaf-like structure that protect the flower when it is a bud. They support the petals of flower. Stamen. It is the male part of a flower. It is made up of the anther and the filament. The anther carry the pollens, which looks like yellow powder dust. Filaments are stalks that support the anther. Carpel. This is the female part of a flower. It consists of the stigma, style and ovary with ovules. The stigma is the sticky tip of carpel. The long neck of the carpel is called the style. The broad base of the carpel is called the ovary. It contains one or many eggs called ovules. The transfer of the pollen grains from the male part, that is stamen, to the female part, that is carpel, is called pollination. Plants have flowers. Plants can be divided into two types: flowering plants and non-flowering plants. Flowering plants are rose, jasmine, sunflower, lotus, tulip and daisy. Non-flowering plants are algae, mosses, mushrooms, etc. Flowers and their lifespan. Annuals. Flowering plants that complete their life cycle in 1 year are called annuals. Children, in 1 year, they grow to full size, bloom, produce seeds and die. Zinnia, marigold and sunflower are examples of annuals. Biennial. Flowering plants that complete their life cycle in 2 years are called biennials. They grow to full size in the first year and produce flower and seeds in the second year, after which they die. Sweet William, primrose and bellflower are example of biennials. Perennials. Perennial plants live for 3 or more years. They produce flowers and then seeds within one season. They not die at the end of the season. Lavender, rose and lily are example of perennial plants. Flowering season. Flowers do not bloom in all season. Some flowers are seasonal. Flowers that bloom in the spring are sunflower, zinnia, tulip and lily. Some of the summer flowers are hibiscus, dahlia and daisy. Well-known autumn flowers are marigold, rose, and zinnia. Some of the winter flowers are dahlia, tulip, and jasmine. Who is attracted to flowers? Different insects, bats, birds, etc. visit flowers for nectar. Bees make honey from nectar. Children, nectar is a sweet liquid that is found inside a flower. Most of them are attracted by the color or smell of the flowers. Bees get attracted towards the iris flower because of its blue and yellow color. Butterflies get attracted towards carnation because of its bright red or pink color. Flies get attracted towards rafflesia flower because of its odor. It smells like rotten meat. Children, rafflesia is the largest flower in the world. Uses of flowers. Some flowers like cauliflower, drumstick flower, broccoli, etc. are eaten as vegetables. In marriages and festivals, flowers are used to decorate houses, doorways, etc. Flowers are used for making floral patterns called rangoli on the floor. Some flowers such as cloves, saffron, etc. are used as spices. Flowers are also used to make incense sticks. Honey is made from the nectar of flowers. Flowers are used to make medicine and cosmetics. Flowers are used to make garlands and bouquets. Extracts of flowers like rose and hibiscus are used to make drinks called sherbets. Flowers are gifted on special occasions like weddings, birthdays, anniversaries, etc. Women wear flowers on their hair to enhance their beauty. Sweet smelling flowers are used for making perfume, soaps, and lotions. Journey of flower from garden to flower seller. A florist is a person who sells flowers. They buy flowers from a wholesale market or mandi. Some florists make beautiful garlands and sell them. The cost of flowers varies depending on their availability, season, etc. Flowers are one of the most beautiful creations of nature. Flowers are a source of happiness and beauty. Recap short. A plant has a root system which is found underground and a shoot system which is found above the ground. Roots are of two types, taproot and fibrous root. Roots provide water and nutrients to the plant and also hold it firmly to the ground. Plants are divided into two groups, flowering and non-flowering. Flowers are the most beautiful part of a plant. They differ in shape, size, and color. The main parts of a flower are petals, sepals, stamen, and carpel. Different flowers bloom during different times of the year. That's complete your chapter, children.
Thank you, children. Stay home, stay safe.